Brad, how did it feel to be back out there?
Yeah, I mean, it felt great. Just getting back out there, just good practice and then being cleared yesterday. Just felt awesome. Good feeling to be back out there with him. Yeah, awesome.
What level of confidence did you have Friday night that you get a good positive review?
What do you mean, like with the
concussion protocol?
Yeah, I mean, I felt good. The doctor said, hey, if you feel good and all is clear and you're passing on your test and you're good to go. So that was just a huge sigh of relief for me. So.
That's the first time it's happening to you, right? In your football career, the concussion?
Yeah, I mean, I might have in high school, I don't know. I mean, there's a few times in high school where I was hit pretty hard. I might have, might not. I mean, I don't know, football, I think it's happened. I mean, it could have happened before, just not as bad as a couple weeks ago.
Is it scary? Is it, like, how would you describe the experience?
Yeah, it just you can tell that something isn't right. I've taken hits before, I've taken hits all season. But that hit a couple weeks ago, I felt different. You know, I stood up, and I didn't feel like myself. That was the biggest thing, just not feeling yourself. My reactions aren't as quick or stuff like that. My mental clarity isn't as sharp. Just little stuff like that is what kind of gives it away.
Brad, 14 take you a little while to get in the rhythm, or did you kind of feel pretty good from the jump up there?
Yeah, I mean, it was a bit hard getting used to the rhythm of the game. Just to get back at it. And I practiced some this week. Practicing the game is a whole different story. Just getting used to the rhythm of it, the speed of it. It was just hard at first. So then I settled down a little bit, but yeah, it was just hard. I'm just glad I got this game over with me and progress. Just get better next week and get ready for the next opponent.
Despite that, I mean, you were incredibly efficient tonight. And you made some crisp throws. I mean, so obviously it didn't take too long for it to come back.
Yeah, I mean, I played all right. Wasn't amazing, I don't think. The defense definitely dealt us out of a lot of situations. Most of the points that they scored, honestly, it was our fault. It was my fault. So there's a lot of things that I can do better. I feel like I didn't play amazing, but the defense made some good plays and the offense. School guys made some good plays, so they helped me out a lot. Just got to go back to the drum board this week and get better.
Brad, Coach Scott talked about just getting back out on this field and pushing through what happened last time you were on that field. How much was that a motivation, or how much did you guys even think about that game when you walked back out there today?
Yeah, well, obviously, the last time that we played at home, that was pretty rough. That was rather not. I mean, we as a team felt like that just wasn't us. That wasn't our identity. That wasn't who we are. It's not the team that you watch our film every week. We felt that we had to bench that and just come back from the bench. And also depend on the turf better than last time for a lot of things.
Brad, along those lines, 14 days ago, this thing could all have gone totally south. Now you're bowl eligible. You're still somehow in the coastal race. You guys have talked a lot about the summer and talked about it again this week in practice, but just wasn't saying about your team that you were able to hold it together when probably a lot of people expect you not to.
Yeah, just a lot of guys have just gotten tight, just gotten closer. Relentless. The season's had a lot of adversity. We haven't had the easiest time. We haven't had games, weeks off, or we haven't had easy opponents. And every opponent's play is tough, just about every single one. And if you're watching, the last however many opponents we've played, the team that shows up on film and the team that shows up on game day is completely different. Little Miami Hurricanes, of course, but we just haven't had it easy. And I think it's credit to our team and just our ability to respond to adversity.
David made that really nice catch. Is the sky the limit for him? It seems like he can really take it to the next level.
Yeah, I mean, no doubt. He's a crazy athlete. He's a true freak. He can jump out of the gym. He can dunk. He can. Yeah, I don't know what his vert is. Probably some crazy. He runs fast. He does everything that you want from a big time skill guy. I guess he's a tight end, but you can also label him a receiver. A flex guy. I don't know what to call him, but. He's just a crazy athlete and do some big things for us. He's getting better. Each week, he's making more and more plays and getting more involved in the game plan. So, the sky is the limit for David.
Anything else?
Brad, next week with North Carolina, thoughts on that game? And then, obviously, a chance for you guys to redeem yourself in a big game. What needs to happen for you guys to get a better result?
Yeah, it's just, that's a big team. It's a good opponent. He's got to take this week of preparation seriously. It starts tomorrow, starts tonight, making decisions. Then come back tomorrow, going watching some of them, breaking them down, and just figuring out all their tendencies. This next week of prep, has to be just like, you know, all the last ones, it has to be just like Florida State, just like how we prepped against Virginia Tech. I mean, it's got to be serious. And these have to just detail our work and just be pros.
Yeah.